And I literally never even opened this. Is this still good? I bought this a long time ago. Oh, expiration date is December 2017, you guys.
Raven Elise TV.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Raven. Today I'm here for kind of a different video. I wanted to do a what's in my fridge video, which is a thing here on YouTube. I've definitely seen other people do it. It's kind of like what's in my purse, what's in my diaper bag, what's in my fridge. It's just a way for you guys to be nosy and also a way for me to share what my favorite foods are, kind of what my favorite little secret hidden items are that I can recommend to you, and for you to get, I guess, an idea of the types of things that I eat. So hopefully that makes sense, and hopefully you guys discover some new cool food items that you might want to try. So this is my refrigerator. And on the outside, I keep a couple of little mementos. This is a Mother's Day card from Zaya that they made at school. And this is a card from Daisha from when I hit 600,000 subscribers. Shout out to Daisha for being a good friend. And I also have these magnetic letters on here, which I actually painted gold myself to match my aesthetic. And I have a little whiteboard. It's like a marble background with a gold frame. I got this from Target. And as you can see, it comes in handy to keep your grocery list. Right now I have my full grocery list because I'm about to get groceries, but normally what I use it for is like when I run out of something, I notice it in the refrigerator, I grab the marker and I write it down. That way I don't forget to get it next time I go shopping. So right now my refrigerator is pretty sad and empty, and that's because I'm about to get groceries. So you're probably thinking I'm about to take a trip to the grocery store, but no, actually I'm about to order my groceries. And I promise you guys, this video is not sponsored. I am not being paid to talk about this app that I'm about to use. They don't even know I exist, but this is just an app that I love that I've been using for like 3 years and that I would highly, highly recommend to you guys. And I wanted to like tell you guys about it. I've already talked about it on my other social media, but just in case you didn't see that, I actually order my groceries from my phone from an app called Shipt. So I have an account and I literally just go onto this app. I choose my store. My store of choice is HEB. It tells me when the next delivery is available. So since it's almost 1 p.m. right now, the next delivery is between 2 and 3 p.m. So I'm gonna select that, and then I can just browse through everything that they have on the store. It even tells me what's on sale. It gives me like coupons and little extra discounts. And it's literally just like online shopping or Uber Eats or whatever. You go through and pick what you want, add it to your cart. And a feature that I really like on here is the buy again button. So once you've already gone through and ordered your groceries once, it'll save it for you so that the next time you order your groceries, you don't necessarily have to go through the whole app and pick out everything again. You can just go to your saved list and add all that stuff back into your cart again, or pick certain things that you know you already want. And then you would just go ahead and place your order. And then within that delivery window, somebody is gonna come knocking on your door with your grocery bags ready to go. So the app itself is really awesome. You know, you pay the membership fee, pay the delivery fee. Actually, if it's an order over, I think $25 or $35, it's free delivery. So it's not even a delivery fee, it's just like the membership fee. So just the app by itself is already awesome. It's already good, like it's a good idea, but there's more. And the reason why I wanted to tell you guys about it is because I have gotten a ton of free groceries by using this app. Once again, this is not sponsored, this is not a scam, this is not like literally. Like I said, I discovered this app about 3 years ago because I was living in Dallas and I didn't have a car to be able to go to the grocery store, so I needed to figure out how to get my groceries. Started using it 3 years ago, and then I realized that they have like a little referral coupon code thing. Like, you know how like on Uber or Uber Eats, you have your little code, and if you share your code, that person gets a free Uber ride and you get a free Uber ride. And same thing for Uber Eats, that person gets free food, you get free food. They have the same thing for this app, and you can actually use the credit to go towards your actual groceries, you guys. Like, you can get free groceries. So they have a couple of different little coupon codes. They kind of change them up every now and then. Right now, the coupon code, oh, this is actually good for you guys because it's a $50 credit. So if you guys use my code or my link down below, check the description box down below, you guys can get a $50 credit for your membership fee. So it's normally $99 a year. Basically, you pay $99, you get a year's worth of free grocery delivery. So it's $99 flat fee, and then from there on out, it's basically free to use the app. So that's what I have. I paid the $99, and now I get my groceries delivered whenever I want. But if you guys use my coupon code or my link, you get $50 off of that. So you basically get it for half price. So it's only $49 a year for unlimited free delivery, which is like good, because if you think about how often you might use this app throughout the year, $49 flat fee is really nothing. So definitely check out my my link or my code down below if you guys want to sign up for this app. You'll be able to sign up for only $49 instead of $99 a year. And like I said, this is not sponsored, this is not a scam, this is just something that I personally use. I wanted to tell you guys about it and save you guys some money on it. And so the way it works is you guys will get that $50 credit and I'll also get a $50 credit. So that's how you end up getting free groceries. So if you guys sign up for it, make sure to tell your friends about it. Share your code with your friends so that they sign up, they get to sign up for a discount, but then you also will get the $50 credit, which basically means you can turn around and use that $50 credit to get $50 worth of free groceries with free delivery. So definitely make sure that you go on here after you sign up and get your own personal code and share it with all your friends. I recommend sharing it on your Twitter, share it on Facebook, tell your mama, tell your auntie, be like, girl, use my code, okay? This app is legit. You could use my code, get a discount, and then I'ma get some credit, and then you could get some free groceries. We all get free groceries, everybody wins. So just wanted to hook you up with that. Like I said, my code will be down below. I'm about to place my order, and then when it comes in about an hour, I will show you guys everything that I bought and show you guys everything all nicely organized in my fridge and tell you guys kind of about all of my favorite food products. And voila, 3 bags full of groceries just got delivered straight to my door. The girl was so nice, just brought them straight to me. This is like so clutch, you guys. So clutch. So I'm just gonna put everything away real quick. Okay guys, just put my little groceries away. Now it is time for the moment of truth. What is in my fridge? Keep in mind, yes, I just got new groceries, but I just restocked on the typical things that I would normally get, and I did not clean out my fridge ahead of time, so we don't know what we're gonna find. This is a super-duper realistic view of what is in my fridge. Stuff that I keep in here, old stuff that might be in here, and then the typical foods and drinks that I like to buy. So I guess we'll just start on the top row. This is like a really weird video. I hope you guys don't think it's weird. But okay, top row, first thing you're gonna see right here is my Nestle Coffee Mate coffee creamer. Fun fact, this is actually dairy free. Even though it's not marketed as like a dairy free thing, it is dairy free. It's not made with real milk. So this is what I use for my coffee. I have the vanilla caramel one, which is almost empty. So I just got a new cinnamon vanilla cream one. And then I also have apple juice. I always get 100% apple juice for Zaya. This is her juice of choice. And then this time I actually got something that I don't normally get, which is this white crayon strawberry. This was my favorite juice as a kid. My mom used to get this for us, and I haven't had it in so long, and I just wanted it again. So I got this, but normally I don't get juice for myself. Over here to the side, we got some minced garlic. I have this old one that honestly I need to throw this away because this has been, oh wait, it says used by August 23, 2019. Dang, garlic lasts for a long time. I could have sworn that this was gonna be like, what's it called when the thing is too old for the date? Expired. I could have sworn that this was gonna be expired, so that's why I got a new one, but I guess it's not expired. But anyway, yeah, I keep minced garlic because I'm lazy, so this is easier for cooking. I also have some Silk dairy-free yogurt alternative. So this is made with soy instead of dairy. It's actually pretty good. This is the vanilla one. I honestly don't know what this is. I think it's caramel
It came with like this thing. It was like apples and caramel. You're supposed to dip the apples in the caramel, and then I didn't use the caramel. I don't know why I have this in here. Back here is my sun-dried tomato and pesto graveyard, because I like to make sun-dried tomato pesto pasta a lot. And I'm one of those people who, like, when I'm actually at the store, I forget what I have and I end up buying it when I already had it. So I end up with like three of the same, like, I don't know. So I've got like the sun-dried tomato and basil stuff, sun-dried tomatoes, a pesto, another one of the freaking same pesto back here. And this is a naughty thing, because this actually has Parmesan cheese in it, so I really should not be eating it, but it's so good. This is, oh, raspberry jam. I did not even know that that was back there. Then over here on the other side back here, I keep a little box of baking soda. You're supposed to put baking soda in your fridge and freezer to help keep it fresh. I don't know, but I just do it. And then the last thing back here is this chicken sauce, which actually, you guys, this stuff is so good. It even says on the bottle, it says, if you like Zaxby's and Raising Cane's sauce, you'll love this. And it's actually true. Like, this tastes very, very similar to like the dipping sauce that they have at Raising Cane's, which I love. So yeah, I just discovered this a while back. And as you can see, I've actually used like half of it. It's so, so good on French fries, chicken strips. Second shelf is basically all new stuff that I just got today. I have a Lunchable for Zaya's school lunch. Sometimes I give her Lunchables. I also have a little thing of little mini baby juice boxes. These are Sesame Street organic 100% juice, apple juice, also for Zaya's school lunch. I have eggs. I always buy just this little mini carton of eggs, because it's just me and Zaya, so we don't go through a lot of eggs, and they'll go bad by the time I get to them if I buy an actual whole like dozen of eggs. So I just buy 6 eggs. And then back here, this is also for Zaya's school lunch. These are the Go-Go Squeeze. They're like apple sauce pouches, and these are apple strawberry. Over here we have organic diced pears. This is also for Zaya. Sometimes I put them in her lunch, sometimes she eats them like with breakfast and just for a snack at home. These are Abe's Wild Blueberry vegan muffins. They have no allergens in them whatsoever. No milk, no nuts, no eggs, no soy, no nothing. And they actually taste good, you guys. Like, I eat these too for breakfast sometimes, but I mostly get them for Zaya to have for breakfast. And I mean, not that Zaya necessarily needs vegan muffins, but I just thought these were cool and they seem healthier and they actually taste good. And I can already hear the comments saying that I'm wasting energy because I'm leaving my refrigerator door open too long, but let's try to hurry up. So the next shelf down here, we have cinnamon swirl bread and blueberry bagels. So no, neither of these things are gluten-free. They got all types of gluten in it, but really the bread is mostly for Zaya because she likes cinnamon toast, and sometimes I make her peanut butter sandwiches with this cinnamon bread. And then also the bagels, Zaya eats them, but truthfully I eat them too because I just love blueberry bagels. And I know that there are gluten-free, dairy-free bagels out there somewhere, but I haven't found any good ones at my store. So this is just like a guilty pleasure of mine. It's really bad. Over here we have these little things that I get from HEB specifically. They're like apple slices, carrot sticks, little crackers, little cheese cubes. They have a bunch of different varieties. This one has carrots, grapes, pretzels, and cheese cubes. And these are basically like what I consider healthy Lunchables. So like sometimes I'll just give her the regular Lunchables, but I like to get these because it actually has like fruits and vegetables in it for her lunch. Then I have a little thing of honey mustard sauce from PDQ, which is a chicken restaurant. This is actually a shrimp taco left over from yesterday. I have one lonely strawberry Jell-O cup. I have these little apple fries, which are also for Zaya's lunch. So it's like pre-sliced apples in little individual baggies. So you just throw it into the lunchbox. And apparently it's a product of Argentina. I don't know why they needed to put that on there, but these are really, really convenient for Zaya's lunch. And then back here we have blackberries, some old strawberries that are really dry and crusty, some raspberries, and some new strawberries that I just got. All right, so in this drawer, this is what I call the meat drawer. In this Tupperware container, it's actually bacon. What really irritates me about bacon is that usually the package is not resealable, so I never know what to do with it, but I just figured I could put it in this little Tupperware thing. Then we got some bacon bits because when I make salads and stuff, I like to put bacon bits in my salad. Is that ghetto? I don't know. And then I just got some breakfast sausage. I know pork is bad, but as much as I want a pet piglet, I really love bacon and sausage. I also have some other different kind of like the microwavable breakfast sausage in here from before. Got some hot dogs down here. I personally hate hot dogs with a burning passion, but Zaya likes them, so I give them to her occasionally. Also got some cheese sticks, which these are actually honestly really old. I bought them thinking that they would be good for Zaya's lunch, but she will not eat them. So these are probably expired. They're Paw Patrol cheese sticks. And then I have some dairy-free vegan cheese. It's supposed to be like provolone cheese. I had tried some, like I was trying a bunch of different cheese. It was all nasty. This is the one package that I had left over, and by then I had just given up because all the other cheese that I tried from this brand was nasty. So I never even ended up using this one. And it was expensive too. All right, down here we have got some green grapes that I just got and some spinach. I like to add spinach to my pasta, to my eggs, and just make spinach salads with it. And then also just a cucumber, because cucumber is good. This is just chicken breast. I bought some chicken breasts because I'm gonna make some pasta and stuff, and you can put it in salad, and you know, y'all know what chicken breast is. Okay, so now moving on to the refrigerator door. Top shelf has butter. I prefer to use the spreadable butter instead of sticks of butter. And yes, I know that this is not dairy free, but like, it's just butter. And then this little shelf right here is like my condiments shelf. And honestly, I really don't use condiments that often, I just realized, because a lot of these things have been here for like 2 years because I just never use them. I have honey mustard. I actually have the Whataburger honey mustard as well. And I have the Whataburger honey butter, like if you get their honey butter chicken biscuits. Remember that vlog a long time ago when I tried to make Whataburger honey butter chicken biscuits? Yeah, this is from that. That was like at least a year ago and I basically never used it again. Oh, I literally never even opened this. This is dairy-free Caesar salad dressing, and I literally never even opened this. Is this still good? I bought this a long time ago. Oh, expiration date is December 2017, you guys. I also have mayonnaise, which a lot of people think is dairy, and it's not, because mayonnaise does not have milk in it. It's made out of eggs and olive oil. So I can eat regular mayonnaise and be fine with it. It's not vegan, but I'm not a vegan. Does that make sense? Creole mustard back here, which is my favorite kind of mustard. I love anything that has like a crunchy texture to it. I know, I'm weird. As you can see, I really like honey mustard. Oh, and one more thing I forgot to show you is I actually just bought this today. This is Newman's Own balsamic vinaigrette salad dressing. This is like really one of my favorite salad dressings. And this is the one thing that I actually do use, because when I do make like my spinach salads, I will use this type of dressing. Moving on, we just have whole milk because Zaya drinks regular whole milk, so that's for her. I have orange juice, and I like the orange juice that has lots of pulp. I know you guys are gonna think that's so freaking disgusting, but like I said, I like crunchy textures. So this is actually my orange juice of choice. And then I have almond milk, vanilla almond milk, because I don't drink regular milk, so this is for me to make smoothies and if I need to bake with it or like eat cereal or whatever. And then down here, this is my bougie beverage shelf. And this is one of my favorite shelves in my refrigerator because this is actually a hobby of mine. Okay, so this is gonna sound a little weird, but I have developed a new hobby or interest
in bougie health food drinks or like weird drinks. So you know how you go to a grocery store or Whole Foods or something and they always have that section of drinks that like they're all really expensive, they're all like weird things, vegan things, kombucha and weird tea and weird lemonade and stuff like that, and they all cost like $3 a bottle and it's just all this crazy stuff. I have developed an interest in that section of the grocery store, and so what I like to do every time I see that in the store is I like to try a new bougie health food beverage. So over time, I have tried a bunch of different weird drinks, different types of kombucha, different types of protein drinks, energy drinks, coffee drinks, vegan drinks, just all that type of like probiotic, also probiotic drinks, juices, green juices, like I tried turmeric milk the other, like just, you know, health food drinks. So this first thing over here is a LaCroix. A lot of people think that it's pronounced LaCroix and it's not, it's LaCroix. This is a mango LaCroix. This is just sparkling water. A lot of people hate these because they're not sweetened at all. It's an acquired taste and I actually do really like them and usually I keep a bunch of them, but I actually only have one left right now. Back here I have a Dasani water bottle, which is also a guilty pleasure because people say Dasani is really bad for you because it has sodium, like a small amount of sodium in it or something, but it tastes good. I don't know. Oh, it has a pure crisp taste just like it says on the bottle. So I drink Dasani water, and then I have this Naked juice smoothie. This is the Mighty Mango. Next I have mango kombucha. This is by Synergy, and kombucha is basically a fermented drink. It's really good for you. It is an acquired taste because it kind of tastes like vinegar when you first taste it because it is fermented, but I've grown to really like it and it's really good for you. And this mango flavor is actually really good. And then this next drink is actually my newest discovery. It is called Koya, I think it's pronounced, and it is a plant-based protein drink. It's really hard to find protein drinks that don't have gluten or dairy in it, but this is dairy-free and gluten-free. This is a vanilla bean flavor. And it's non-GMO, soy-free. It has 18 grams of protein in this drink. And I had the cinnamon flavored one already and it actually tasted pretty good. So I was really excited to find this because plant-based protein is harder to find. Next, I have this juice. This is spicy pomegranate. It's half drank already, but they make a bunch of different types of juice drinks. So this one has lemon, maple syrup, pomegranate, and cayenne pepper. Back here, we have another juice drink. This one is by Suja. I don't know how you pronounce it. And this is a probiotic drink. So another healthy food drink, organic water, strawberry, raspberry, lemon, honey, and tart cherry, and it has probiotics in it and it's sweetened with stevia. I really like this brand. They have a bunch of different flavors. They have green juice as well. We have another juice drink back here, but this one is actually a chia berry blended smoothie. So this has a chia like crunchy texture to it. I don't know if y'all can see that at the bottom. I actually really love chia seeds because like I said, I like crunchy textured things. And then we have a palm, which makes, you know, the pomegranate stuff. This is the pomegranate honey green tea. It is an antioxidant super tea. And then I have a random bottle of wine. I just picked this up because when it comes to alcohol, I really just want it to be fruity and sweet because I'm a little baby and I don't have a mature palate for alcohol. So I just picked up this wine because it looked like it would taste good. It's a sweet peach wine and it actually did taste pretty good and it was cheap. So I mean, as you can see, I drank most of it, so that's pretty much all I ever have in terms of alcohol. And then down here at the bottom, I have a random bottle of like Pedialyte because, you know, mom life. So yeah, you guys, that is what I keep in my fridge. I feel like this is actually an interesting video because it's kind of like you're getting to know me, you're getting some food ideas, maybe even some meal ideas, and yeah, I don't know. I had fun making it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I know it's kind of random and weird, but if you did enjoy it, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!